हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. आई एम डॉक्टर माधुरी चटर्जी फ्रॉम बीबीटी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज चिमनपुरा, एंड वी हैव कवर्ड अ क्वाइट अ बिट ऑफ सिलेबस सो फार. एंड टुडे फॉर दैट मैटर आई विल गिव यू सम असाइनमेंट्स विच इज़ होमवर्क, एंड आई विल टेक अ स्मॉल लिटिल टेस्ट ऑल्सो विच इज़ 30 marks. आई विल बी इन द कोर्स ऑफ टाइम अलॉन्ग विद द पेपर वुड बी गिविंग यू द हिंट्स एंड द क्लूज एंड द आंसर्स. But kindly do the assignments, all of you. The first question is fill in the blanks with suitable words, which is a 10 marks question. The children are studying in the dash. Now, I have said in the paragraph noun, which is sitting, studying in the class or in the house or at home or in the college or whatever. So you have to fill a proper noun there. Dash by vegetables, and you have to fill a pronoun here, and pronoun I mean a personal pronoun, that is I, we, you, he, she and they. So think of one, the appropriate one, and fill it up. We dash hard to get good marks. We work hard, or you struggle hard, or you whatever, you have to fill a proper verb here. The world is dash a pandemic. World is struggling with a pandemic or facing a pandemic, is acting against a pandemic, so you have to fill a proper verb here. The college, now this is an apostrophe, yes. This is a college building or the college ground or the college property, whatever, is empty. You have to fill a possessive noun here. They healed, reflexive pronoun, that is which is reflecting on yourself. They healed themselves, or that is a reflexive pronoun. The boys are having dash. You have to fill an uncountable noun with something. You cannot count something like tea or water. Next is dash is a strength, is an abstract noun. Abstract noun, as I said, is goodness and cleverness and charity and virtue, and all these are abstract noun. Then again, dash is coming. It's an indefinite pronoun you have to fill. Indefinite is somebody, nobody, anybody, whatever, that is indefinite pronoun. She dash fruit from the market. She buys or purchases or sales or whatever, that is a verb. So you have to fill an appropriate verb. That is a 10 mark question. Then you have to make sentences using a proper noun. So as simple as Ram is going to the college, countable noun. The girls and the boys are sitting in the class, personal pronoun. Is Ramesh is a good boy, and impersonal pronoun is it is raining hard or it is raining today. An irregular verb, and you know regular and irregular verb which you can convert. So you have to fill an irregular verb here. Then you have to give the meaning of the following words, which is again a 5 marks question. First is pandemic. Pandemic means mahamari, which we are facing, all of us, which is COVID-19. So that's called a pandemic. Foeticide. Foeticide is killing the fetus. It's killing, bhrun hatya, which is in Hindi you call it bhrun hatya. So foeticide, you make a, give the meaning and make a sentence. Patriarchy is a patriarchal society, so it is a structure where male dominated. The society is patriarchal. It is the domination of the male which we usually face. Gender equality is that boys and girls are all equal, so that's a gender. Gender is ling, so equality is samanta. And the last word is heal. Heal means ठीक हो जाना, स्वस्थ हो जाना, जैसे लोग अब धीरे धीरे हील हो रहे हैं और भगवान करे हो जाए. सो दैट इज हीलिंग. सो वी शुड प्रे टू गॉड दैट वी हील. एंड नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, दैट इज ऑल्सो 5 marks क्वेश्चन. एंड द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द पोएम विच आई डिड यस्टरडे विथ यू. एंड अगेन रीड द पोएम केयरफुली. द पोएम इज वॉइस ऑफ एन अनवॉन्टेड गर्ल चाइल्ड. एंड आई एम आस्किंग यू अ क्वेश्चन हियर, अ 5 marks क्वेश्चन विच इज काइंड ऑफ 3 lines. That what is the message of the poem? What is the message of the poem? How should we treat the girl? How the girl should be treated in a society? Why there is a difference in between the boys and the girls? Why gender equality is required? Why we have female feticide? So what is the message the poet is trying to give? And the name of the poet, as I said, is Sujata Bhatt. And the last question is, you have to make 5 sentences using SVOCA. Now remember, S is subject, V is verb, O is object, C is complement and A is adverb. I have given you enough exercises. Go through them. I am not saying that in every sentence you are supposed to have a subject and a verb and an object and a complement. But some sentences might have just the three, some sentence might have four, and some sentence might have all the five SBOCA. So kindly make sentences. This is a 30 marks paper. Please do it. Thank you so much, bachcho. Thank you so much.